1, 2, 3, testing. All good to go. Hey man, hi. Hey man, hi. So today's topic is something which I have already covered in my previous videos, but that video was in Hindi language, and some people have started calling me out for not speaking in English. So I have decided that this video would be in English, and also I would cover this topic much more in detail. So let's get started. Let me come straight to the point. Is learning German important before coming to Germany? Yes, definitely. You need to learn the language. By learning German, I mean that you are very well off with the language and you are able to communicate in German spontaneously. I have seen that almost everyone learns German just for the sake of getting a Goethe certificate. So why learning German is important before coming here? One of the main reasons why learning German is important is that people in Germany speak German. Like, it's very obvious. I have seen people who ask me these kinds of questions as to why language is important. Like, this is the one of the main reasons why learning language will help you here, because people do not speak English. They speak only in German. By this I mean is that people prefer German over English. In Aachen, there are a lot of people, like mostly the young population, who are able to speak in English. But in other parts of Germany, people prefer to speak in German, and most of the people are not well versed with English. So it all comes down to the preferences which people have. So people mostly give preference to the one who is able to speak in their language, that is German. The second reason for having the skill of being able to communicate in German is that it helps you to find a job, both part-time as well as full-time. If you are a student who wish to work part-time in some non-technical jobs like working in a hotel or maybe something like that, you need to be able to communicate in German, as you have to converse it with people. Also, if you want to apply for some student assistant jobs in the universities, which are particularly known as Hilfswissenschaftler, or in short HIVs, being able to communicate in German plays an important role in that as well. Like, if you will check the job openings page of the HIV, you will always find this particular sentence, which is Gute Deutsch Kenntnisse in Wort und Schrift, which means good German speaking and writing skills. After completing a master's degree or a bachelor's degree, when you apply to companies, you need to prepare your cover letter as well as your resume, your CV in German. So there are basically 3 rounds which I am aware of, which you have to pass before getting a job in any company. The first round is when you send your applications to the respective companies, and if the companies find your application interesting, they call you. And during the telephonic round, they ask you some basic questions which are in German. Only after you pass that telephonic interview, then you are called for the personal interview round. And sometimes you have to give the personal interview in German. You can use the technical words which you have learned during a course in the English technical words, but the sentences should be in German. So you need to be able to communicate in the language. I'm stressing on this word communicate a lot, because as I said earlier, people learn the language just for the sake of getting a certificate. And honestly speaking, companies do not look at your certificates. They only check whether you are able to speak in German or not, and they figure it out in the telephonic interview and the personal interview round. Certificates have their value only if the university to which you are applying to has asked for it. And to the best of my knowledge, you need not submit any German language proficiency certificate for applying to any English short courses in Erwin. The next thing which I wanted to tell you is that, which may come as a surprise to you, that being able to speak in German sometimes helps you to get an accommodation. A cheaper one, I would say. There are a few communities here which provide cheap accommodations to students, and they always prefer students who are able to speak German. I want to show you an ad from the Wege Gesucht site, and it's WG Gesucht in English and Wege Gesucht in German. So this is the ad, and I'm currently reading it from my laptop. It's written in here that, attention international and Erasmus students, we are looking for tenants speaking German fluently. I think the picture is more clear to you now. And believe me, getting a cheaper accommodation is one of the most important things which you should focus upon as well. And also, you can see how German language plays an important role in helping you to get one. Now, it entirely depends upon you whether you want to join a class or you want to learn the language on your own. There are certainly many people who have learned the language on their own. And one of the examples which I can give is about Bharat in Germany. He always speaks about these things, and in one of these videos he had mentioned that he has learned German on his own, and I truly respect him for that. So I would say that you figure it out what works for you. You do you. I'm a very big fan of Gary Vaynerchuk, and he always talks about this word, which is patience, and I think that it applies to every situation. So his sentence is like, you need to be patient as fuck. Like, it also applies to learning a language. You need to be patient as fuck. You cannot expect yourself to complete A1 level and then start speaking in German. You need to practice each and every day. Even if you learn up till B1 level, I learned up till B1 level, still I'm not able to speak in German because I did not practice a lot. So the only key to learning the language is consistency and practicing. Consistency in practicing every day. You can give at least 2 to 3 hours every day, and then only you can reach up to a particular level where you are able to spontaneously speak the language. So I know that I'm pretty much late about talking about New Year resolution thing, but why not make this as your New Year resolution? Why not make this as your goal of speaking German by the end of this year? By the end of December 2020, you would be able to speak in German. Not as fluently as you expect, but at least you would be far much better from what you have started from. In the end, I would say that being able to communicate in German is a kind of superpower which you would have. And like I've seen many international students who are not able to speak in German. And if you can, then you will kind of dominate everything. Dominate, not kind of dominating people, but in terms of dominating the communications which you would have with other Germans, or the dominating the situations. And believe me, if you are even if you're new to this country, and if you can speak the language, you don't need anyone's help. And that's the biggest advantage you would have of not relying on anyone for anything. I hope whatever advices I have given to you in this video, you consider them seriously. And by the end of this year, by December 2020, I hope that we are able to speak in German, or at least be much better from what we have started. I have my German language exam by the end of this month on 27th of Jan. It's of A2.2 level, and I wish that I pass that exam. So that's it for today's video. If you are new here, consider subscribing to this channel. And if you want to connect with me further, you can follow me on Instagram. I hope you are having a great day. Please learn German. See you in the next video. Bye.